Okay, good morning. Welcome to ICS. My name is Anderson Xie, and it's wonderful to meet every one of you here at ICS Church to worship our God together. We are glad you are able to join us here today for this Sunday service. And I think I saw a lot of you are not wearing masks anymore. So I might as well just greet one another. Can you greet the people sitting next to you? Thank you. Wonderful. You may be seated. ICS is a multi-denominational Christian church, so in compliance with Chinese government regulations, ICS services and events are open to foreign passports or foreign permanent residence holders only. So all participants are required to produce the foreign identification before entry, and you can have a photocopy scanned on your smartphone would be suffice. I probably also use Mandarin to say this again. ICS 每周都会跟大家呼吁说，请你配合我们的同工检查那个我们的证照。那这个是按照中国政府的规定，那也能够请大家就不管你来了几次，那还是能够让我们的配合我们同工的工作。谢谢。So some other procedural announcements. So there is an overflow room located on the third floor foyer area. And it's set up for parents with babies and also some for the elderly and also for local parents whose children are in Kids Church or Trailblazers. So, and also for those you, if you drive this morning, you can get a special hotel parking coupon for a freight rate, RMB 15, at a counter outside the second floor foyer. And hotel also offers us a special restaurant meal discount for ICS members. So you may refer to the bulletin for, there is a QR code, and you also can ask hotel staff. With the upcoming basic counseling training course, you can take note of the adjusted program schedule and the cost. So the course now is shortened to 5 weeks from 10 weeks, and you may refer to the schedule as shown on the bulletin, and subsequently the cost also expected to be reduced to half. But for this course, we are target to cap at 20 signups, so please sign up as soon as possible. And you can refer to the bulletins and inserts for more information and how to register for the events and activities. And ICS is a cell church, so every week we promote two cell groups. So this week, the first cell group we are promoting is Light and Salt. It's a Chinese-speaking cell group. They are family CG with children. They meet on Sunday right after the 9 a.m. service nearby the hotel. And the second group we are promoting is Greatly Blessed. It's a young married couples and working adults. They meet on Friday evenings around Huangpu, Hongqiao Ru, or Jing'an district. So please join our cell group, and you can visit our cell group connection booth, just located outside. On the, if you go out from that door, they are on the left-hand side, and you can talk to any one of them there. They will give you more introductions. It's not only those two cell groups, also other cell groups information in Shanghai. ICS 是一个细胞小组的教会，那我们希望各位弟兄姐妹都能够至少参加其中一个小组。那我们现在很多小组现在都已经恢复线下了，那所以如果说您聚会结束的时候还没有参加任何的小组，可以左手边跟我们那边会有同工，会有他们小组的成员跟您介绍我们小组的那个情况。And also announcement for the In Christ Singapore is our ICS sister church. The meeting location and the time are presented. for your and also your friends' information, if some of you are visiting Singapore or you have friends or relocating to Singapore, so please join them. So also at this time, we would like to invite those who are joining us for the first time. If you are just moving to Shanghai and this is your first time being with ICS, I won't ask you to say anything. You probably just, you can wave or just please stand at where you are. We just want to recognize you and give you a warm welcome. Anyone? Any newcomers, please? We have a sisters there. Anyone else? Anyone new to Shanghai? No, just join us. Okay, so you will get a welcome card, and after the service, please go to, there should be our brothers and sisters outside to talk to you and give you more church informations. Also, as a tradition here at ICS, we like to recognize our members who have been worshiping with us for 6 months or even longer. And if you are moving out from Shanghai, you are going away, we also like to have a short prayer with you. Anyone? Anyone living in Shanghai? Okay, that's great. Okay, so may I ask you, please stand up. Let's have a short prayer before we start our worship. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, we dedicate this wonderful Sunday morning to you, and we saw our brothers and sisters gathering together as body of Christ. Before we start our worship, Lord, please you take care of everything we are currently thinking or worrying, Lord, because we know you grant us the peace. And Lord, through worship you, Lord, please let us all come before you and standing in your presence. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Good morning, church. Okay, are you ready to praise the Lord? Okay, good. And Psalm 92 says, it is good to praise the Lord and make music to your name, O Most High, to proclaim your love in the morning and your faithfulness at night. Amen. Lord, you make us glad by your deed, O Father. We sing for joy for works of your hand. Amen.
Can stand against you. My feet are planted possible. All things are possible. All things are possible. All things are possible. Your praise is always on my lips. Your word is living in my heart. And I will praise you with a new song. My soul will bless you, Lord. You fill my life with greater joy. Yes, I delight myself in you. And I will praise you with a new song. My soul will bless you, Lord.
Hallelujah. Praise Him. Amen. Let's praise Him. Let's lift Him up in the praise of God in this place. Praise the Most High God. The God that can do the impossible. Amen. And we lift Him up.
Thank you. lifted higher. I belong to you. I am nothing without you.
You
be lifted high. You be lifted higher. I belong to you. I am nothing without you.
You be lifted high.
You be lifted high. You be lifted higher. I belong to you. I am nothing without you.
In every victory.
In every victory. In every trial. My soul will sing, be lifted high. In every heartbeat, all of my life, Jesus forever be lifted. Higher, you be lifted high. Higher, you be lifted high.
Higher, you be lifted high. Higher, you be lifted high. Oh, Father, you're a beautiful God. We love you, Lord. Let us praise you with your voices.
上被的。 救主，你的爱是我生命全部，一生要敬拜我亲爱天父，你无条件的爱让我心的满足。你无条件上生命给主爱的耶稣，完全顺服，完全降服，因你恩典使我得以释放，你的宣召没有怀疑，我的生命献给你，背起世界跟随你，愿你的荣耀彰显在我生命，为了谁不要忘记你如何为我生命，耶稣我爱你，喜乐地跟随你。顺服，完全降服，给你恩典是我的一生奉你，你的宣召没有怀疑，我的生命献给你，为这世界跟随你，现在我生命，我的心不要忘记你如何为我生命，耶稣我爱你，喜乐地跟随你，整个我属于你的幻想，带下你生命，献给你，背起十字架跟随你，愿你的荣耀彰显在我生命，我的心不要忘记你如何为我生命，耶稣我爱你，喜乐地跟随你，我的心 耶稣我爱你，喜乐地跟随你。
Father, we praise you and we thank you that you have called us to be your children, Father. Thank you that, Father, we can consecrate our life to live it according to your will, O God. We thank you for the wonderful privilege to be blessed with all the spiritual blessing in the heavenly places in Christ Jesus. Father, we thank you for this opportunity to gather here. We'd like to take this opportunity to pray for world peace, Father God. We pray for the war in Ukraine to stop. We pray for the crossroads tension to subside in the name of Jesus. We pray for your wisdom to rest upon world leaders to come to terms with the fact that, Father, we need to live peacefully with one another. We pray for your blessing to be upon this earth. We give you praise and thanks, Father God, that we can continue to worship you with our tithes and our offering. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Please be seated. As the offering bag is going around, I'd like to bring your attention to the free gift that we gave you last Sunday. It is still available. You can pick it up after the service at the information table, all right? So please feel free to pick as many as possible to bless your friends. And you can also remind yourself regarding who you are in Christ through all the cards that's placed here.
我们的奉献袋在中间传递的时候，大家可以看一下这个免费的礼物，上周剩下来的，欢迎大家多多取用，可以给到你的朋友，给到包括自己。
Now let's take some time to pray for Aisri. I mean, this is her first time interpreting for me. And
谢谢 Pastor Daniel 要为我来祷告，是我第一次在台上做翻译。
I gave her the warning yesterday that I will not be following the script because there's just too much to cover this morning.
昨天 Pastor Daniel 已经警告我过了，警告我过了哈，他不会按照这个他的这个稿子来走。
Okay, let's pray for her. Father, we thank you for the anointing to interpret upon Aisri, even as she speak forth your word, that it will come forth in clarity, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Let me begin this morning's sermon by asking you a question.
我想先来问大家一个问题啊。
How many of you have watched the show Top Gun 2?
大家这里有没有看过《头号玩家2》的？
Oh.
Top Gun 2, 头号玩家。
没事。
哦，壮志雄心啊，另外一个翻译。
Yeah. Basically, if you watch that show, don't just look up for Tom Cruise, okay?
不要只在电影里面看找那个 Tom Cruise 看。
I would like to remind you of this scene that happened in Top Gun 2.
里面有一个片段。
Just as the formation of four aircraft was approaching the enemy's territory.
当他们低空下降，避开雷达那个和这个防空导弹。
You will remember there was one information that was given by the early warning aircraft.
会有一个预警的那个信息给到他们。
Telling Tom Cruise that the coast is clear, you are clear to descend.
Tom Cruise 说已经安全了，可以下降了。
And that's why they descended and went through the terrain, right?
这就是他们下降的时候。
It was an early warning and information given to the fighter pilots.
这就是提早给到那个航空驾驶员的一个警告。
You said, but Pastor, what has it got to do with today's sermon?
你可能问说，牧师今天和今天的讲道有什么关系呢？
Well, the passage for today is an early warning given by Jesus to us.
今天我要给大家分享的一个圣经也是耶稣给我们的一个预警。
That as you listen to the word this morning,
当你在听今天的讲道的时候，
you must be ready to receive the word.
你应该准备好你的心来接受今天的道。
Because the devil would not want you to receive the word this morning.
因为魔鬼不想让你拿走今天的道。
Because there's tremendous power in the seed of the word of God.
因为在这个种子里面有强大的力量。
So turn with me to Mark chapter 4 verse 13 to 20.And he said to them, Do you not understand this parable? How then will you understand all the parables? The sower sows the word, and these are the ones by the wayside where the word is sown. When they hear, Satan comes immediately and takes away the word that was sown in their hearts. These likewise are the ones on stony ground, who when they hear the word, immediately receive it with gladness, and they have no root in themselves, and so endure only for a time. Afterwards, when tribulation or persecution arises for the word's sake,Immediately they stumble. Now these are the ones sown among thorns. They are the ones who hear the word. And the cares of this world, the deceitfulness of riches, and the desires for other things entering choke the word, and it becomes unfruitful. But these are the ones sown on good ground. Those who hear the word, accept it, and bear fruit, some 34, some 60, and some 100.
马可福音又对他们说，你们不明白这比喻吗？这样怎能明白一切的比喻呢？撒种之人所撒的就是道，那撒在路旁的，就是人听了道，撒旦立刻来，把撒在他心里的道夺了去。那撒在石头地上的，就是人听了道，立刻欢喜接受，但他心里没有根，不过是暂时的。即使为了道遭受了患难，或是受了逼迫，立刻就跌倒了。还有那撒在荆棘里的，荆棘里的，就是人听了道，后来有世上的思虑、钱财的迷惑和别样的私欲进来，把道挤住了，就不能结实。那撒在好地上的，就是人听了道又领受，并且结实，有30倍的，有60倍的，有100倍的。
How much this sermon is going to influence your life will be very much dependent on you.
今天这篇讲到对你的生活有多大的影响，将取决于你。
Yes, you.
是的，取决于你。
You will not witness in the natural what the word of God promises unless you open your heart to His word.
除非你向神的话语敞开你的心扉，否则你不会自然而然的就见证到神的话语所应许的。
To be ready to receive and accept the word is a choice made by us.
准备好听到和接受这道是我们自己的选择。
In fact, one of the reasons for the word to be ministered after worship is to ensure that we open our hearts to the word of God.
事实上呢，敬拜之后再讲到的原因之一呢，就是为了确保我们在敬拜时将自己交给神。
Worship makes our heart moldable by God.
啊，这样会打开我们来接受这道的工作。敬拜也使我们的心更容易被塑造。
We are reminded of the lordship of Christ, the awesomeness and the greatness of God during worship.
我们在敬拜中呢，被提醒基督的主宰地位、神的可畏和伟大。
I started off the sermon by reminding you that it is an early warning for us regarding the importance of the word.
我以此篇讲到的开章向大家来提醒哈，就是说我们要对这个道有一个接受。
You know, as a pastor, many church members sometimes ask me, "Can you pray for me that I have faith in God?"
很多那个我们的会众哈来到找我说，牧师，请你为我祷告啊，因为这个为我祝福。
Let me have faith in God.让我对上帝有信心。
让我对上帝有信心。
But faith comes by hearing the word of God.
但是呢，听道来自于信道来自于听道，听道来自于主基督耶稣的话。
And without faith, it is impossible to please God.
没有信心也不可以得到神的喜悦。
So how do you build up your faith?
那我们如何来建造自己的信心呢
？You build up your faith as you listen to the word this morning.
当你听今天的讲道的时候，你就在建立你的信心。
What gives substance to your faith?
给你信心的实底的是什么呢
？It is the word of God.
是神的话语。
Amen. Now let me give you a very simple example that I've always been giving.
我想给大家一个我经常给大家的一个例子。
Now men have lost confidence in man's word.
人们会丧失对人的话语的信心。
Example.Let's say you were on the way to church this morning, and your son or your daughter said, "Dad, I want to go to Shake Shack."
比如说今天早上你来教会的路上，你的孩子跟你讲，爸爸，我要去那个一个餐厅，汉堡店。
Yeah, McDonald's is not so happening right nowadays, right? I want to go to Shake Shack.
我要去一个汉堡店。
And then you say, you know, son, we're going to church right now, and we will go to Shake Shack after the church service.
你可能告诉说，孩子，我这个，我们先去教会，去完教会以后，我们去这个 Shake Shack.
You know something? Your 5-year-old son will say, "Yes, we are going to Shake Shack after church."
那你五岁的孩子就说啊，太棒了！这个去完教会之后，我要去这个汉堡店。
Make sure you go to Shake Shack after church and not go eat dim sum.
去完教会以后，你要确定啊，带你孩子去这个汉堡店，而不是去吃那个点心了。
Because the more you do it, your children will lose confidence in your word.
如果你经常那么做的话，你就在你的孩子面前丧失你话语的信任度。
So if we become doubtful in man's word, we will also be doubtful in regards to what the word of God tells us.
所以，当我们如果这么做的话，可能对神的话语也是同样的。
Amen.So we need to go back to accept that the word of God has authority in our lives.
所以我们要回到神的权柄的话语里面。
Now some people also tell non-Christians say, "Pastor, I don't understand the Bible."
有些人说啊，牧师啊，我不太明白圣经。
The first step,
第一步
is to accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior.
是先接受主基督耶稣成为你的救主。
Why? Because the first ground is the hardened ground. Until you say, yes, I receive Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior, and I open my heart to Him, then you will understand the word.
直到那一天你说我接受主基督耶稣做我的生命的主和救主的时候, 你才打开了你的心。
Amen. All of us are given a measure of faith.
所有的都是, 信心是有强弱的。
Very good, right? Yeah, so the more you listen to the word,
当你越多的来听到神的话语的时候,
the more you will grow in faith.
你就增加了你的信心。
Amen?
Amen.
Praise God.
感谢主。
Now, the sower sows the word.
撒种之人所撒的就是道。
It is the responsibility of the pastor to prepare the word.
牧师需要忠实的, 传撒神的话语。
There are different kinds of teaching.
有不同的讲道。
There are different styles of teaching.
也有不同风格的讲道。
Now, let me tell, some people like teach, some of us like teachers teaching very much. Okay. Many of us like the gift of teaching because it is very clear in the delivery of the word.
很多人喜欢教师的这个事工，因为他是很清楚的在传递神的话语。
Now let me get example, okay, so that you understand what I'm talking about.
举个例子。
Now there are the fivefold ministry.
我们有五重事工。
Apostle, prophet, evangelist, pastors, and teachers.
有信徒，使徒，先知，传道人，牧师，教师。 Thank you.
Right. All of us like the teacher.
我们都喜欢那个教师的那个。
Because it's very clear in the way of presentation.
因为很清楚的可以来做这个讲道。
But all the teaching is important.
所有的教导也是非常重要的。
Some people will tell you through a narrative. That means they'll repeat the story to you.
有些人会以段落式的来讲道，就是他不断的重复。
The teacher will cross-reference throughout the whole Bible and bring clarity to the topic.
教师也会通过圣经来把更清楚的信息传递给大家。
The evangelist normally talk about the gospel.
传道人更多的说的是福音。
So you need to be able to receive from different teaching.
所以我们应该准备好自己来接受不同的讲道。
So you say, oh, Pastor, why do you say that?
牧师，你为什么这么讲？
I say that is because sometimes when you have different people teaching from this pulpit,
我这么说是因为你会听到不同的人在这样的讲道。
They have different style of teaching.
他们有不同的风格来讲道。
And if you do not adjust to their style,
如果你不调整自己,
you will switch off.
你就会关闭自己。
And when you switch off, you will not receive anything.
当你关闭的时候, 你就收不到任何东西了。
Amen.
Amen.
So, good. So don't switch off, okay?
所以, 别关掉。
Now, the seed represents the word of God.
总之就是神的道。
This is one of the reasons why we should, okay, let me say it carefully.
我要很小心的说。
There are a lot of people, no, shouldn't say that. So. Okay, sometimes church members call me and say, Pastor Daniel, will you counsel my friend?
有些会众会找到我说, 牧师，你能不能帮我的这个, 朋友来辅导一下。
And they are not from ICS.
那他们不是ICS的。
Normally I'll say no.
通常我会讲不行。
Because I respect the senior pastor of the church that they come from.
因为我要尊重我们, 高级的, 其他人牧师。
Yeah, because when you come for counseling,
当你来做辅导的时候,
and when the pastor meet up with you,
当牧师见到你的时候,
Christian counseling always point you back to the word.
基督徒的辅导总是把你带到神的话语里面。
Amen.
Amen.
So when you are counseled by your own pastor,
当你被你自己的牧师来辅导的时候,
you have already heard the teaching of the word through the pulpit.
你已经在这个讲台上听到了这个牧师的讲道和教导。
So you're on the same wavelength as your pastor.
所以你跟你的牧师是站在同一点上的。
So when he counsel you,
所以当他辅导你的时候,
you understand where he's coming from,
你就会明白他是从哪儿来的。
And then we exercise that faith together.
然后你们会来一起实践你们的信心。
There will be agreement in that counseling. There will be an agreement between the counselee and the counselor.
那在你们之间会有一个认同。
And then you pray together.
然后你们一起祷告。
That's the effectiveness of Christian counseling.
这才是一个有效的基督徒的辅导。
So the seed of the word of God determines the harvest.
所以神的, 神的到来决定了你的这个收获。
If we plant the seed of the word on wisdom, then we will ask God for wisdom, and wisdom will be seen in your life.
如果我们播下智慧的道，我们就会见证神的智慧呢，在我们中间运行。
Now let me repeat that. The seed is the word of God.
我来重复一下，那个种子就是神的道。
So when we teach on wisdom, on many occasions through this pulpit,
当我们教导智慧的道的时候，在这个讲台上
，and the more we encourage you to ask God for wisdom，
那我其实要更多的来鼓励你们向神来求智慧。
You will tend to say, "Yes, Father, I, your word says that I can ask you for wisdom. I ask you for wisdom right now."
你可能会说，天父啊，对啊，是你让我来向你求的，我现在就要向你求智慧。
And God will give you liberally without reproach. God will give you wisdom liberally without reproach.
神会给你这样的一个自由，让你得到。
And you will see wisdom being expressed throughout this church.
那你就会看到智慧就在我们这个教会里面来延展。
Wisdom can be seen.
智慧是可以被看到的。
Why?
为什么呢？
Because when King Solomon built his kingdom,
因为当所罗门王建造他的这个王国的时候
，The Queen of Sheba was amazed by his management.
那个 Sheba 王后就。啊，西巴女王就是被她的这样一个建造。
So when you ask God for wisdom,
所以当你跟神要智慧的时候
and it's being expressed in your home, in your business, in your school, wisdom can be seen.
所以当你在你的商场上，当你在你的家里、学校里面来向神这么求和表达的时候，你就可以得到。
So whatever we sow from this pulpit will be seen in the church.
所以我们在这个讲台上所种下的种子，就会在我们的教会里面见到收获。
But first of all.
但是首先第一点
You must be open to the word of God.
你必须要对神的话语保持一个开放的心态。
Amen.
Amen.
Now, let me give you another example.
我再给大家一个
We've been talking about identity in Christ, right?
我们在讲基督耶稣里面的身份。
And we have given you this card.
这个卡片我给到大家了。
It's for you to look at it every day.
希望大家每天都看。
It says, I'm made in the image of God.
这个卡片上说我是按神的形象被
造的。And the likeness of God.
就好像神一样。
I must worship God in spirit and in truth.
我必须在心里和灵里敬拜神。
So the more you go through this word,
当你更多的来看到读到神的话语
的时候 the more secure you are in Jesus Christ.
你就在主基督耶稣里面有这样的确信。
Because your identity begin to be transformed from the world's identity into your identity in Christ.
因为你的身份来自于这个世界的身份就被更新成为基督。
So if we teach on the ability to walk in the law of the spirit of life in Christ Jesus, and we are able to overcome the law of sin and death, we will see victorious Christian living in our midst.
所以当我们在这个里面有确信的时候，我们就可以看到一个得胜的基督徒的生命。
Amen.
Amen.
But the prerequisite is you must belong to the good soil.
但是这个一个前提是你必须是一个好的土壤。
We talk about the first soil.
我们刚才说了第一种土地
which is the hardened ground,
硬土。
So when the word is being sown,
当种子撒下去的时候
the Bible, Jesus told us that the devil will come immediately to take away the word.
耶稣告诉我们那个撒旦会来立刻把种子拿。
These are the people who are not open to the gospel.
那这样的人呢，是他对这个福音并没有一个敞开的心。
And they are not, they will not understand the gospel. They will not understand the word.
他们可能没有明白这个道或者这个话语。
And then I told you last Sunday that we need to be the good soil.
那上次我也跟大家讲过，我们必须要成为那个好土。
It is the good soil that will produce 30-fold, 60-fold, and 100-fold.
因为是好土才可以结实30倍、60倍、100倍。
And when you begin to do that, you will not be a spiritual infant. You will be a spiritually matured Christian.
当你那么做的时候，你就不再是一个婴儿的基督徒，而是一个成人基督徒。
There's tremendous power in the seed.
在种子里面有强大的力量。
But it can only germinate, grow, and take root under the right condition.
但是这个种子只能在正确的土壤里面。
The greatest challenge is if we have been the stony ground instead of the good soil.
比较危险的是，如果我们是那个石头地的话。
Now, when I was in the army,
当我在部队的时候
we were sent to, you know, dig a trench.
我们去挖渠。
It is very tiring.
很累。
You know, when you dig the first, when the spade goes down,
当那个去铲土的时候
you will hit the rocks,
可能就碰到了那个石头
sometimes you will hit the roots,
还有那个植物的根。
You need to take the effort to clear the rocks and the stones, right?
要很多努力。
So that you loosen the ground.
石头和根剪掉，然后松土。
So Jesus is telling us.
耶稣告诉我们。
Remember the early warning system.
记得那个预警系统吗
？So he's telling us, if today you have your heart is filled with rocks.
他告诉我们，如果今天你的心是被那些岩石石头所挤住的话
，You must clear it.
你得把它弄干净。
Who clears it?
谁来弄呢
？You clear it.
是你。
Nobody can clear it for you.
没有人可以帮你。
Oh, some people say, "Oh, God, open my heart, Lord."
啊，有些人说啊，神啊，来打开我的心。
No.
不是这样。
You're a free moral agent.
你是一个自由的人。
You open your heart.
你打开你的。
You say, God, my heart is open to receive your word right now.
你可能跟神说，我的心打开了，我现在就准备接受你。
Whatever is cluttering my heart, I want to remove it.
什么在我心里搅扰的话，都请你把它清除。
We adjust our attitude.
我们必须要来调整。
We adjust our attitude towards the word of God.
要调整对神话语的态度。
Are you the stony ground?
所以你是那个，你的心是石头地吗？
Verse 16 to 17 says, These likewise are the ones sown on stony ground, who when they hear the word immediately receive it with gladness, and they have no root in themselves, and so endure only for a time. Afterward, when tribulation or persecution arises, for the word's sake, immediately they stumble.
话语说，那撒在石头地上的，就是人听了道，立刻欢喜接受，但他心里没有根，不过是暂时的，即至为道遭了患难，或是受了逼迫，立刻就跌倒了。
Now all of us are receiving the word right now.
现在每一位都在接受神的话语。
And all of us can be excited. Wow, praise the Lord, wonderful.
我们每一个人都可以很兴奋地说，感谢主，太棒了。
But don't be shallow, Jesus says.
但是不要浅薄，耶稣说。
You must go home and think about the word.
你必须回到家里，还要来默想神的话语。
Because our relationship with God is, it takes time to build that relationship.
因为要花时间跟神来建立关系。
Sometimes as Christians, we just want a formula to get.Us out of a situation.
有时候作为基督徒，我们只想要一个快速解决的方案。
Faith in God is not a formula.
但是对神的信心不是一个公式。
Faith in God is a relationship.
与神是一种关系。
Sometimes it takes time for the word of God to be manifested in our lives.
有时候需要等待等神的应许的话语在我们生命中呈
现。It is through faith and patience that we inherit the promises of God.
是通过信心和耐心，我们才接受到传承到了神的。
We need to be patient.
我们需要耐心。
Sometimes we need to allow the word to take root in our hearts.
很多时候我们需要听到很多的话语，让这个话语在心里扎根。
Many of us can be very impatient.
很多我们中间很多人可能不是很有耐心。
Recently, I read something from this sprinter called Usain Bolt.
最近我读到一篇东西。
The fastest sprinter from.I think Nigeria, if I'm not wrong.
是尼日利亚的一个信息。
Jamaica, sorry, thank you very much. Usain Bolt said, you know, I take 4 years to prepare to run 9 seconds.
我准备了四年就是九秒钟的一个表演。
I take 4 years to prepare myself to run 9 seconds.
四年的准备九秒的呈现。
He said, some people...Quit after 2 months.
他说有些人可能两个月以后就放弃了。
You know Usain Bolt is the 100 meter sprinter, right? He said, I take 4 years to prepare for Olympics just to run that 9 seconds.
他是为奥林匹克来准备的，他准备了四年，就是获得了那个九秒。
Many people like to be a sprinter.
很多人都想成为 sprinter.
But they want to see.Immediate results.
但是就是渴望见到那个立刻的效果。
So likewise for the word of God.
就好像神的话语一样。
It takes time to germinate and take root in our lives.
是需要时间来生根发芽的。
And we need to also be careful. We need to look out.
我们也要当心来警醒。
That and also to remind ourselves that there is an enemy out there who wants to steal the word from us.
我们要知道那里有一个仇敌是想偷取我们的话语的。
And Jesus tells us that it will come through tribulation and persecution.
那耶稣已经告诉我们了，是通过苦难和这个试炼来的。
Let's look at John 15 verse 19 to 20. It says, If you were of the world would love its own. Yet because you are not of the world, but I chose you out of the world, therefore the world hates you.Remember the word that I said to you, a servant is not greater than his master. If they persecuted me, they will also persecute you. If they kept my word, they will also keep yours.
约翰福音，你们若属世界，世界必爱属自己的，只因你们不属世界，乃是我从世界中拣选了你们，所以世界就恨你们。你们要纪念我从前对你们所说的话，仆人不能大于主人，他们若逼迫了我，也要逼迫你们，若遵守了我的话，也要遵守你们的话。
So Jesus has already reminded us that there will be persecution in our lives as a Christian.
所以耶稣早就已经警告过我们，作为基督徒，我们的生命中会受到逼迫。
We have been called to be the salt and light of this world.
我们被神称为是世界的光和盐。
When you refuse to compromise with your values and principles, it will cause people around you who are unethical to feel very uncomfortable.
当你要向这个世界的不向世界的价值观所妥协的时候，你周围的人可能会觉得不舒适。
So what is persecution?
那逼迫到底是什
么呢？ Let me give you the definition.
Okay.
It is literally refers to chase or pursuit, or figuratively means to put to flight or to pursue with repeated acts of enmity. To persecute is to harass in a manner designed to injure, vex, grieve, or afflict.It describes the process which is meant to annoy with persistent or urgent approaches as attacks, pleas, or importunities.
逼迫的这个字面意思就是指追逐或者是追赶，比喻用反复的敌意的行为使人逃跑或者是追赶。迫害是指一种旨在用伤害、烦扰、悲伤或折磨的方式进行骚扰。它描述的是。目的在于以持续或紧急的方式来烦扰的过程。
Now, let me give an example. We have talked about the Christian stand on LGBTQ and gender fluidity.
给大家一个例子，我们之前讨论过关于性少数人群这个话题。
And this is the Christian stand.
这个是基督徒的一个立场。
And let's say.One day, if you are being persecuted for this stand,
我们打个比方，有一天你被这样的一个立场所逼迫的话，
you must not give up your Christian faith.
你不应该放弃你的基督徒的价值观。
Amen.
Amen.
Because Jesus said, "If they persecuted me, they will also persecute you."
因为耶稣已经告诉过我们，当他们逼迫我的时候，也一定会来逼迫你们。
The second kind of persecution that comes is.In regards to your conviction towards the word of God.
第二种的逼迫来自于对神话语的确信。
Second Thessalonians chapter 1 verse 3 to 4 says, We are bound to thank God always for you, brethren, as it is fitting, because your faith grows exceedingly, and the love of every one of you all abound towards each other, so that we ourselves, both of you among the churches of God, for your patience and faith in all your persecution and tribulations that you endure.
帖撒罗尼迦后书，弟兄们，我该为你们常常感谢神，这本是合宜的，因你们的信心格外增长，并且你们众人彼此相爱的心也都充足，甚至我们在神的各教会里为你们夸口，都因你们在所受的一切逼迫患难中仍旧存忍耐和信心。
So the Bible is telling us that the Apostle Paul concurs what Jesus says.That your faith will grow exceedingly, and please be also reminded that tribulation and persecution will come as you develop your faith in Him.
耶稣说，通过这个使徒保罗呢，说他们的信心格外增长，并且也告诉他们呢，其实他们所受的这个逼迫，他们在经受了逼迫和患难以后，他们的信心会更加的增长。
Remember, in the main passage, it says, "When you receive the word." Tribulation and persecution will come because of the word's sake.
请大家记得，就是在圣经里面说到，为了神的话语会有患难和逼迫来到。
The purpose is to steal the word.
那个目的就是要偷走那个话语。
Amen.
Amen.
Are you here with me? Now, let me give an example. Example, okay? Let's say we've been talking about the fact that.The Christian marriage is built on covenant.
举个例子，基督徒的这个婚姻是建立在一个盟约的关系上的。
That for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, till death do us part.
无论是富贵或者是贫穷，无论是健康或者是病痛，我们只有死才能把我们分开。
All our wisdom are shared.
我们所有的智慧都是分享的。
All our resources are shared together.
所有的资源也都是共享的。
This is our conviction.
这是我们的确信。
Now, remember,
请记得。
The devil wants to steal the word.
那仇敌是来偷取这个话语的。
So when you go home,
所以当你回家的时候
，and you start quarreling,
你开始吵架
，and you begin to operate in individualism again,
以这个个人主义来行事。
You need to remind each other.
要彼此提醒。
Don't let the devil steal the word.
别让仇敌把那个话语偷走。
I say, don't let the devil steal the word.
别让仇敌窃走话语。
Your wife is not your enemy.
你的太太不是你的。
Your husband is not the enemy.
你的先生也不是你的
仇敌。There is an unseen enemy that wants to steal the teaching of the word from your life.
有一个可能看不到的仇敌想从你的生命中把那个话语偷走。
Because this passage says that the devil will come immediately to steal the word.
因为圣经里面说那个仇敌来了，立刻就来把那个话语偷走。
Amen.
Amen.
Now, let me give you one more example.
再来一个例子。
I've been teaching on this identity in Christ for very long.
关于基督里面的身份这个话题，我已经教导了很多次。
When tribulation comes,
当患难来的时候。
Let me give you the definition of tribulation first.It says, tribulation, according to Strong Concordance and credit to Precept Austin, the extended version is tilipsis, means press together, squash, hem in, compress, squeeze in, right? In turn, derived from the word tlau, originally expressed sure physical pressure on a man. Tilipsis is a strong term which does not refer to minor inconveniences, but to real hardship.
我们来先看一下苦难的这个定义啊，Tilipsis 这个词呢，它的原意是压碎、压在一起、压扁、卷缩、压缩或者是挤压的意思。
那、
最初表达了对人的纯粹的身体上的压力。那 tilipsis 又是一个很强度、很高强度的术语，它不是指轻微的不便，而是指真正的困难。
So it's real hardship that will come.
所以是非常非常难的境况。
So tribulation, the reason tribulation comes into your life is to steal the word.
那苦难来到你的生命中，目标是为了偷走话语。
So if you look at this picture,
看看这张图片。
Tilipsis tribulation is like you are being pressed.
苦难就是你被压榨。
Like if you throw olives and then you press in order for the olive oil to come out.
如果把那个橄榄扔到这个里面，其实它是通过压榨来挤出橄榄油。
So Jesus has already given us an early warning that tribulation will come, and the reason tribulation comes in your life is because the devil wants to steal the word from you.
那耶稣已经早就警告过我们啊，我们会有苦难在生命中。那苦难的目标就是因苦难的原因是因为魔鬼想要偷走在我们生命中的话语。
So I need you to remind each other when you go home today.
所以当我们回去的时候，我希望大家可以彼此提醒。
When you experience certain hardship,
当你正在经历这样的苦难的时候
，when you go through certain persecution,
经历一些逼迫的时候
，remind each other, don't let the devil steal the word.
让我们来彼此提醒，不要让仇敌偷走我们心中的话语。
Amen.
Amen.
Can you remind each other?
可以提醒彼此吗
？That your spouse is not the enemy.
你的配偶不是你的仇敌。
There's an unseen enemy.
有一个看不见的仇敌。
Because this is what Jesus meant in the parable.
因为这就是那个耶稣在比喻里面告诉我们的。
That tribulation and persecution is in your life because of the word's sake.
苦难和逼迫就是为了神话语。
Then some people say, oh, if that's the case, then I don't come to church and I don't listen to the teaching of the word. Then there will be no stealing from my life.
那有些人会说啊，这样的话我就不来教会了，我也不要听到。
Then you'll be facing all the tribulation on your own.
那可能你就是自己在面对你一切的苦难。
Sometimes we think that the devil is a gentleman.
有时候我们想啊，魔鬼是一个绅士。
Oh, as long as I don't go to church, I don't become a passionate Christian, the devil will leave me alone.
那他可能会觉得啊，我只要不去教会，然后我也不跟从神，那个魔鬼就会远离我。
He will not, because the Bible tells us that the thief comes to steal, kill, and to destroy.
他不会的，因为圣经告诉我们，魔鬼来，仇敌来，就是要偷窃、杀害和毁坏的。
哦、你有很多老师啊！
谢谢大家，非常多。
Now let me give you one example.
给大家一个例子。
Many years ago, when the Soviet Union was open,
很多年前呢，当那个前俄罗斯
，and many evangelists flew into Russia to conduct healing crusade.
俄罗斯在那个体育场等地敞开大门的时候呢，很多传道人就
And you know when the evangelist preached the gospel, you will see signs and wonders.
那当很多传道人在举行大规模的布道会时的话，布道会的时候，我们就会看到很多的这个医治。
At that time, the Orthodox churches weren't ready to receive the new Christians.
那个时候，他们没有准备好要接受主基督耶稣。
Because the country just opened.
因为那个国家才刚刚打开，对这个福音才刚刚打开。
So many Russians received Christ.
那很多俄罗斯人他们接受了主基督耶稣。
And many of them came forward to be prayed for.
他们就前来布道会，希望被祷告。
To be healed.
被医治。
And then they went home.
然后他们就回家了。
Because the churches weren't ready to receive the thousands of Christians.
因为当地的教会还没有准备好来接受上千万的这个信徒。
10 years later.
十年以后。
When the churches became stronger.
当教会更加的强大稳定的时候
，They went to knock on the door to preach the gospel.
他们开始敲门去传道。
Some of these Russians who went for the crusade said, "I tried Jesus, it didn't work for me."
那有一些当地的人呢，就说啊，我去过这个布道会，我已经试过这个耶稣了啊，
Why?
不灵。
Why? Because they have never been taught that miracle is instantaneous, healing is a process.
因为可能他们从来没有被教导过神迹是。瞬间发生的，而医治可能是一个过程。
The word was stolen from their lives.
那神的话语就已经从他们的生命中被盗走了。
Now, today,
今天
when evangelists begin to have crusades, let's say in India, in Bangladesh, or in Africa,
当我们的传道人在印度、孟加拉等地传道的时候
，they have learned their lesson.
他们已经从这里学到了。
They will partner the local churches.
他们会和当地的教会来形成合作
关系。They will have 1 week of teaching.
他们会教导一周。
They will teach the word for 1 week.
他们会教导神的话语。
And then they will have the crusade.
然后他们有这样的一个布道会。
So when people are saved,
当人被救赎以后
，there will be enough people to follow up with the new believers.
那就会有足够的当地的教会来跟随他们。
So that the word of God will not be stolen.
所以神的话语就不会被偷走。
So remember,
所以请记得
，we must not belong to the category of the stony ground.
所以我们不要让自己成为那个石头，心是石头地的那一类。
We must be able to till the ground.
我们要来耕地。
Remove the stones from our lives.
把石头从自己的生命里。
Turn the stony ground into the good ground.
拿走，然后让自己的生命成为一个好的土壤。
This is what Jesus is telling us.
这就是主基督耶稣告诉我们
的。Don't be the hard ground.
不要成为硬土。
Don't be the stony ground.
不要成为石头地。
Don't be the ground that is full of thorns and thistles.
不要成为那个荆棘布满的土地。
Be the good ground.
成为好土。
Because when you are the good ground,
因为当你是好土地的时候
then the word of God will produce 30-fold, 60-fold, and 100-fold in your life.
那神的话语就会在你的生命中30倍、60倍、100倍的结实。
So how do we deal with those tribulations in our lives?
那我们如何来应对这样的一些苦难在我们生命中呢
？What should be the conviction of the seed that we should have sown or learned from the pulpit to help us weather through the storm of life？
那我们在讲台上所听到的这些话语和道呢，是可以帮助我们来应对生命中的苦难的。
Let me bring you back to the earlier part of this sermon。
我想回顾一下前面我们说的。
I said when we teach on a certain topic，
当我们在教导某些话题的时候
，the more we teach that topic。
越多的教导
the more you will see it happening in the church.
你就会看到更多在教会会众生命中发生的转变。
Let me give an example.
举个例子。
When we restarted church,
当我们重新开放教会的时
候 we took about 3 weeks to teach about praise and worship.
我们用了3周的时间来教导大家敬拜和
What is praise, right? And what is worship? And how do we stand in the glory of God?
什么是敬拜？什么是站立在神的荣耀之中？
And this morning when you came,
今天早上当你来的时候
nobody asked you to clap.
没有人让你拍手
But you started to clap.
但是你就开始拍手了
Because you prepared your heart to praise God.
因为你正在准备你的心来敬拜神
And then we sang the top 3 songs.
然后我们就唱了3首歌。
不是
Sorry.
就是排行榜第三最出名的那首我的心要敬拜你 right? Just now?Why did we do that?
我们为什么这么做呢
Because you have been taught through 3 Sundays.
因为在三个主日你被教导了。
You have received the word, the importance of praise.
那你也接受到了这个关于敬拜的重要性的这个话语。
Right?
对吗？
What do we teach about praise?
那我们关于赞美的教导是什么呢？
Praise in Hebrew means Hallelujah, right?
赞美在希伯来语是 Hallelujah.
And then you praise God this way.
然后我们要
not praise God this way.
然后我们要跳着来敬拜主，而不是这样。
Because that's the definition of praise.
因为这才是敬拜的。
You praise until the spirit of worship come.
这才是敬拜的定义。我们要敬拜直到。
You worship until the glory fall.
直到神的荣耀降下来。
Because it's intentional. It's the same regarding the word.
因为这个是要刻意去做的，这就是神话语说的。
Now, please don't mind me saying this. I'm not scolding you, okay?
请不要介意我下面要说的。
Please come early to church.
请早一点来教会。
It's very sad when it's 9 o'clock. There's only the moderator, myself, my wife, and 5 other brothers and sisters in Christ.
早上九点的时候，我只看到了我自己、我的太太，还有另外五个弟兄，还有我们的工作人员。
Because you're here to worship God.
因为你是来敬拜神的。
It's a corporate worship.
是我们大家一起。
You're here to praise God.
我们是来赞美主的。
It begins in the earlier part of the day when you say, "I'm here to praise God."
一大早我们就要开始跟神说。
And I want to worship Him.
我想敬拜他。
I want to worship Him in a way that is uniquely me.
我想敬拜他，由他来带领我。
It doesn't matter how I sound.
无论我的声音如何。
I want to worship Him.
我就是想敬拜
他。And then we stand in the glory together.
然后我们就一同站立。
And after you have done that, your heart is open.
当我们这么做的时候，我们的
心。You're ready to receive the word.
敞开了，我们就准备好了接受。
But if you just come, okay, today is Sunday, I can't help it, I need to go to church.
如果今天你说，哎呀，今天是周日，真的很无奈的要去教
会。Then you will not receive anything.
那你可能就收不到任何东
西。Your life will not be transformed.
你的生命可能没有翻转。
Why? We have hardened our heart.
为什么呢？因为我们的心是硬的。
Just go through the motion. We just go through the motion of church. 就是。
只是走个程序。
Yeah. Very good. We just go through the motion of going to church and okay, you know, now is the time to sing and give offering and then the pastor will preach 40 minutes or 50 minutes. It's so boring, you know. I mean, it doesn't matter who preaches. As long as your heart is open, you will receive something.Amen.
如果你只是去走个程序，说啊，今天四十分钟，这个牧师要讲到，无论是谁讲到。
Because it has to do with your heart.
因为这和心有关系。
It doesn't. It's not the tone of my voice.
不是我的声音或者是语调。
How much you it is not dependent on how much I preach.
它不取决于我讲了
多少。It's all dependent on how much you're willing to receive.
是取决于你希望接受到多少。
Amen.
Amen.
Like I say. Whether it's 30-fold, 60-fold, 100-fold, it's not dependent on me, it's dependent on you. That's what the Bible says.
就好像我前面说的30倍、60倍、100倍的结实不取决于我，取决于你。
The soil is your heart. It's always the heart issue.
那个土壤就是你的心。
Amen. So every Sunday when you wake up,
每个周日当你醒来的时候,
tell yourself,
告诉你自己,
I want to wake up early.
我要早一点醒来。
I want to go to worship God. I want to go to worship God.
我要去敬拜神。
With my brothers and sisters in Christ. Father, my heart is open.
我要去见到我在基督耶稣里面
的弟兄姐妹。 I want to experience you today.
我要打开我的心告诉神。
I want to worship you in spirit and in truth.
我要经历你，我要在灵里和。
And then I want to open my heart to receive your word.
我要打开我的心来接受你的话语。
Let me ask you.
我想请问大家。
Every Sunday, you need to ask yourself one question.
每个周日你都需要问自己一个问题。
Did you worship God during the service?
你有没有在这个你有没有来敬拜神
？Did you receive anything during the word?
你有没有接受到任何神的话语或者道
？Are you changed when you walk out of the room?Have you been changed and challenged as you walk up the room?
你离开的时候有没有改变？
Because at some point, I'm not talking about emotionalism, okay?
我并不是说情绪上的。
Because when you come and worship God,
当你来敬拜神的
时候, it's between you and God.
那是你和神之间的事情。
You communicate with God.
你跟神在沟通。
And then you receive the word.
你接受到话语。
And when you leave that room,
当你离开的时候,
you would have received something.
你就接受到了什么
you would have met your maker.
你已经见到了你的创造人。
Amen. And then you will grow every Sunday.
那你每个周都在成长。
If Jesus say you will, the word of God will produce 30-fold, 60-fold, and 100-fold in your life.
如果基督耶稣说你的生命会以三十倍、六十倍、一百倍结实的话。
Then your spiritual growth should not stagnate.
那你的这个属灵的成长就应该成长。
If you have stagnated in your Christian growth, then something is wrong.
如果你的基督的生命有所停止，那好像是什么事情不对。
Yes. So, it will only be revealed when you go through a very difficult period.
那这个只有在你经历苦难的时候才会彰显出来。
Regarding how much have you received from the word?
就是你到底接受到了多少话语。
Now let me give you three scriptures.
我想给大家三段经文。
Just to substantiate this truth. Romans 8:35-38 says, Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation, or distress, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or peril, or sword? Yet in all these things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us.For I am persuaded that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor power, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other created thing shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord.
罗马书八章三十五、三十七到三十九节，谁能使我们与基督的爱隔绝呢？难道是患难吗？是苦困苦吗？是逼迫吗？是饥饿吗？是赤身露体吗？是危险吗？是刀剑吗？然而靠着爱我们的主，在这一切的事情上已经得胜有余了。因为我深信，无论是死是生，是天使是掌权的，是有能的，是现在的事是将来的事，是高处的，是低处的，是别的受造之物，都不能叫我们与神的爱隔绝。这爱是在我们的主基督耶稣里的。
Isaiah 43 verse 1 and 2 says, But now, thus says the Lord who created you, O Jacob, and he who formed you, O Israel. Fear not, for I have redeemed you, I have called you by your name, you are mine. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you, and through the rivers they shall not overflow you. When you walk through the fire, they shall not be burned, nor shall the flame scorch you.
以赛亚书雅各啊创造你的耶和华以色列啊造成你的那一位现在如此说你们不要害怕因为我救赎了你我曾提你的名招你你是属我的你从水中经过我必与你同在你淌过江河水必不漫过你你从火中行过必不被烧火焰也不着在你身上
Psalm 34 verse 6 and 17 says This poor man cried out and the Lord heard him and saved him out of all his troublesThe righteous cry out, and the Lord hears, and delivers them out of all their troubles. Many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord delivers him out of them all.
诗篇说，我这困苦人呼救耶和华，便垂听，救我脱离一切患难。一人呼救耶和华，听见了，便救他们脱离一切患难。一人多有苦难，但耶和华救他脱离这一切。
The reason why I gave you these three scriptures is to remind you that the word is the seed.
原因我给大家这三段经文是因为我想提醒大家那个种子就是道
So when you receive these three scriptures
当你接受到这三段话语
And you meditate on it
你默想
You water the seed with the word of you water the seed which is the word of God every day
你就在浇灌神话语每一天
It will take root in your heart
你就会在心里扎根
Faith comes by hearing the word of God
信道来自于听到主基督耶稣的话
OkayIs that what he says?
是这么
说。So when you read these three scriptures,
当你读到这三段经文的时候
for example,
只是一个例子。
When you are hard pressed,
当你被挤压
when you go through tribulation,
经过苦难的时候
what will happen, what will come out?
那什么会显现出来
Remember one of the sermons I said, we should be like a sponge when it comes to taking in the word.
在有一篇讲道上我说过我们应该像那个海绵一样当被挤压的时候
What did I do? I said,
我就做了这样的一个比喻动作
We take in the word.
当我们这样吸收神话语的时候
in the word.
我们把自己浸泡在里面
so when you press,
所以当你被挤压的时候
what comes out?
什么会出来呢
the word.
是神的话语
so when you go through eclipses,
所以当你经历这个压榨的时候
what comes out?
什么出来呢
the word.
是神的话语
so, Remember when you go through tribulation because of the word's sake
所以请你记住如果是为了神的话语你经受苦难的话
Don't let the word be stolen.
不要让这个话语被偷走
Instead, as you walk with God, you say,
而是要说
Father, I praise you and thank you that you love me unconditionally.
天父啊，我感谢你，赞美你，因为你爱我。
Your word says that you will never leave me nor forsake me.
那你的话语告诉我，你不会撇下我，也不会离开我。
Father, I praise you that you are covenant God.
啊，你会说天父啊，你是一个盟约的神。
You will watch over me.
你会看顾我。
Everything that I face in life, you face it together with me.
所有我在生命中要面对的事情，你是跟我一起在面对。
No tribulation, persecution, despair, distress, nakedness, or the sword shall be able to separate me from your love.
没有啊，没有苦难，没有逼迫，没有啊困苦，应该让你让我与你的爱隔绝。
You are carrying me.
你就把我扛在你的肩上。
Nothing will overwhelm me.
没有会淹没我的。
Your grace is sustaining me.
你的恩典就在站就使我站立。
Your word says that many are the affliction of the righteous.
你刚才你的话语说到，
义人有很多患难 ，right? Many are the affliction of the righteous, but you deliver them out of them all.
义人有很多患难，但是就是你来搭救他们。
Father, I do not see the deliverance right now.
我想见到这样的一个
救赎。Father, I do not see the deliverance right now.
天父，我现在没有看到我被救赎。
But I refuse to give up my faith.
但是我拒绝要会放弃我的信心。
I refuse to be moved by the circumstances.
我拒绝我要我会被现在的境况所动摇。
But I will not be moved by what I see, what I feel, what I experience.
我不要被我所看到的、我所听到的而动摇。
I'm standing on your word.
我就站立在你的话语之中。
You are a faithful God.
因为你就是那个信实的神。
You are a good God.
你是一个良善的神。
You will see me through.
你必定和我一起经过。
Through faith and patience, I will inherit your promise.
就是通过耐心和信心，我来承接你的应许。
I will be patient.
天父啊，我会有这个耐心。
I choose to hold on to the word.
我选择来紧紧抓住你的话语。
I refuse the conviction of the word to be stolen from me.
我来拒绝这个话语被偷走。
I stand on your word.
我就站立在你的话语之中。
Amen.
Amen.
That Sunday I said, it is easy to steal the seed.
这个周末我说了，那个种子是很容易被偷走的。
Because the seed is very small, you can just take it and walk.
因为种子很小。
But let's say the eucalyptus tree, when it grows to 100 meters tall and 7 meters wide, try carrying it.
当我们看到那棵树长到那么高和那么粗壮的时候。
So if the word were to take root in your heart and produce 30-fold, 60-fold, and 100-fold, and it germinates and become a strong conviction, no matter what comes in your life, be it tribulation or persecution, you stand.
所以我说种子很小，但是当我们给它时间去生根发芽，长成又粗又壮的时候，我们就不可能被当我们经历苦难和逼迫的时候，我们就不会动摇。
That's a mature Christian.
这就是一个成熟的基督徒。
You know who are those who give up? Sometimes we think that tribulation comes from God.
知道哪些人可能会放弃吗？就是当经历患难的时候。
Blame God, we are offended by God.
我们开始这个怪神，开始。觉得被神冒犯了。
Jesus in this passage tells us that the sower sowed the word.
那耶稣在这个圣经这段经文里面告诉我们，撒种的人撒的是道。
God uses his servant to sow the word.
那神用他的仆人来撒他的道。
Sow his word so that faith will grow in your heart.
用他的仆人撒这个道，所以呢，他的这个道可以在你的心里长成。
God will not do counterproductive work.
神不会自相矛盾。
What does it mean? Give you the word.
什么意思呢？
Jump to this side, give you problem.
给你他的承诺，然后又给你带来这个问题，然后再帮你解决问题。
God is not crazy, you know.
神不是个疯子。
God is not not your problem.
神也不是你的问题所在。
Jesus already said the devil will come and steal.
那耶稣说了，是那个仇敌会跑来偷窃。
When husband and wife have the same teaching.
当那个太太和先生听到同样的教导的时候，当你们也在同一个家庭小组的时候，你们也会彼此提醒。
Don't let the word be stolen.
不要让神的话语被偷走。
Let us stand on the word.
让我们站在神的话语之中。
That is what the word says. We believe the word.
如果这就是神话语所说的，我们就应该去相信它。
Although it takes time, but it will come.
虽然可能要花一些时间，但是它会来的。
This is conviction.
这就是确信。
Amen.
Amen.
In closing.
最后。
The last 4 minutes, okay? We have covered some of the new creation realities in the past. If you can. Show it. He says, He sent Jesus to die for me because I'm worthy and priceless.
我们之前介绍了一些关于我们是新造人的一些事实。
I will not perish, but have eternal life.
我不会灭亡，但有永生。
I'm a child of God.
我是神的儿女。
I'm justified by faith and at peace with God.
我因信称义与神和好。
I'm accepted in the beloved.
我是被蒙爱者接纳的。
I'm heir of God, joint heir with Christ, and will be glorified with Him.
我是神的后嗣，与基督同为后嗣。
I'm strong in the grace of God.
我在神的恩典中强。
I can do all things through Him who strengthens me.
我靠着那加给我力量的，凡事都能做。
In Christ, I'm in His workmanship, therefore He has a good plan for me.
在基督里，我是他的工作，因此他对我有个美好的计划。神要照着他的荣耀的丰盛供应我的一切所需。当我按照他对我生命的旨意做任何事情的时候，我确信他会听到我的祈祷。今天这个道的种子就已经种在你的心里了。我们也给了大家这些卡片。我们也有一个讲这个关于你在基督里身份的。
The more you meditate on your identity in Christ,
越多的你默想在神的话语里
，the more convinced you are that you are a child of God,
你就会更多的有确信你是神的儿女。
No matter what happened,
不管发生什么
，this is who you are,
这就是你。
Your identity is not in the position that you hold in the company.
你的身份并不是你在职场的职位。
Not based on your own strength.
也不是靠你自己的力量。
But based on who you are in Christ.
而是建立在你在基督里是谁。
So remember the seed, the word is the seed of the word of God.
请记得这个话语就是这个种子。
When you receive the word.
当你接受话语的时候。
In regards to your identity in Christ.
关于你身份的这个事实。
The more you think about it.
越多的去思想
the more you meditate on it,
越多的默想
it will produce 30-fold, 60-fold, and 100-fold in your life.
它就会在你的生命中产出30倍、60倍、100倍的果子。
Amen.
Amen.
So in closing, really closing.
最后
you and I,
你和我
determines whether the word of God produces 30-fold, 60-fold.
是那个来决定是否在生命里会有30倍、60倍、100倍结实的那个人。
If your heart belongs to the stony ground,
如果你的心是石头地
，the good news is,
好消息是
，you can declutter it,
你可以把它清除掉
，and make it into a good soil,
让它成为那个好土。
Because Jesus, God has given us the free will to choose,
因为神是给我们自由选择意愿的那位神。
God has never intended for us to drink milk, be a spiritual infant all the way.
神从来没有让我们一直成为那个基督婴儿。
God wants us to grow spiritually.
他想让我们在灵里成长。
To a stage whereby we can rightly divide the word.
到那个我们可以与世界分别出来。
And then we can disciple other people.
然后我们就可以成为其他人的使徒。
Let's bow our head and pray.
我们来低头祷告。
With every head bowed and every eyes closed.
每位低头祷告的时候。
Ask this critical question.
我要问一个关键的问题。
Here with us this morning.
如果你在这里和我们一起做礼拜。
You are not a Christian.
你还不是基督徒。
Never accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior.
你还没有接受主基督耶稣做你的。
I'd like to make this decision to receive Jesus into your heart today.
但你今天想接受他。
I'd like to pray with you.
我想和你一起祷告。
If that's you, would just raise up your right hand.
如果是你，请举起你的右手。
And put it down. Anyone here? Thank you. I see your hand. Anyone here? Anybody else?
举起你的右手。
Anybody else? Okay, for the person or persons who put up your hand, will you say this prayer after me?
举手的，请跟我一起讲。
Say, Dear Heavenly Father,
亲爱的天父
，Thank you for sending Jesus to die for me on the cross.
感谢你派耶稣在十字架上为我而死。
Forgive me of my sin.
赦免我的罪。
Come into my heart today.
今天请你来到我心里。
Be my God and be my Savior.
做我生命的主和救主
In Jesus' name.
奉耶稣的名求
Amen.
Amen.
Praise God. Who of heaven rejoices over the salvation of someone? But before I let you go, I'd like to just invite the keyboardist to just play. And I'd like to pray for those if you are going through a difficult time. I don't need you to stand.I don't need to raise your hands. God is an omniscient God. He knows exactly what you're going through. pray that Father you surround them with good brothers and sisters in Christ to encourage them. And I just commit all of them into your hands, Father. And show yourself strong for them. And that Father you cause them to have a breakthrough in their circumstance. In Jesus' name. May the love of the Father and the grace of Jesus Christ and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you.
Well, I hope you enjoyed the service today, and thank you so much for joining us. And I know that you've been encouraged by the preaching of the word, that you know that God loves you and he has good thoughts toward you. You can continue to follow us on our website and our social media accounts in YouTube, Facebook, and Instagram, or simply drop us an email to keep in touch. And here at ICS, we're a church. We're a family that's blessed to bless the community and the nations. So we hope that you were blessed today and you're really starting to think about how you can be a blessing to your neighbors and those around you. Well, we hope you have a great Sunday ahead. God bless.